Hello boys and girls, Mike here, one of ShortPlay, adding one more game to my games what I have made playlist. Basically, it contains lots of games that I worked on in some capacity over the years. This was the third published game I worked on, the fourth if you include Striker for the Game Boy, which was never finished or released. I only did testing on that anyway. Power Drive for the Commodore Amiga, I think it was ported from the PC, if memory serves. This was between school and sixth form college I was doing this. Got called in over the summer after my work experience to ask if I wanted to do a bit of art. And I was like, art, brilliant. It was map building, mostly. So don't worry, that awful bit of digitised, resized, scaled graphics didn't have anything to do with me. But if you see any tiles that don't match up in the backgrounds, and there are plenty, that's kind of my fault. Okay, let's play this game. I remember this was a flawed game in terms of the way it played. It looks like it's top-down isometric, and you can kind of drive anywhere like skid marks, but you can't. It only goes in 8 directions, and you can oversteer quite easily. Hard game to master. It doesn't make it a bad game. It's just a bit, you know, not quite perfect. Excuse me while I concentrate on putting one go in here. If there's a one, which there isn't. So we're going to use an I. One. And I'm a big kid. I feel like I'm graffitiing something. Although, this game is the first game I was credited on. So I'm going the wrong way. So if you stick around on the front end for long enough, and I mean a good 5 minutes or so, I'm going the wrong way again. I'm not concentrating. There we go. You will see my name in the art credits along with Ali Noble, who probably did the lion's share of the work. I think I put together about a third of the maps on this. Ali was already well into it. I started on it that summer after I left school. I remember it was the same summer The Crow came out at the cinema, and I used my first bit of pay to get The Crow poster, and I have the Fiat Cinquecento. The Crow poster for my bedroom. I remember taking it to work with me, being dead proud of it. And that poster lasted years on my wall. Anyway, happy days. So basically, I spent a bit of time with two machines. I think they were both PCs, taking the PC tile set and putting them into the Amiga and rebuilding all the backgrounds using Mappy. And it was tiled, it was called Tiled, T-I-L-E-D. I think that sound right. That's my memory of it anyway. Summer 94. I still had hair then. Okay, so this is the game. And basically I built a lot of these backgrounds. Possibly this one. If it's not very well put together, it's probably mine. Remember, 15. Oh, I'm stopping a lot here. I'm going to lose time for that. You need to kind of see I've oversteered. Oh, you need to kind of, you know, be quick off the mark, but also get your steering accurate. See, I think it's quite a good game. Again, I don't think it went down badly. It's just it was quite late in the Amiga's life. Not a lot of people were buying games for it at this point. Yeah, I picked something up, usually rubbish, that sort of thing. And it was no skid marks, which was out about the same time, and let's face it, was a better game and a better received game. I do like this though, despite the limitations of the 8 directions, which are making me do the sort of thing that I would normally only do in Wipeout. When I haven't played it for a while, but that was very enjoyable. So what I did is basically tile mapped. I think there were about 60 backgrounds in the game, and I think I did about 20 over the summer. That sounds about right. I might have that wrong. Might be more backgrounds actually. It was a lot of work. It was very intensive. Took a lot of concentration. Remember that much. And I remember while I was there, Denton's celebrating their 10th birthday. Wow, was it the 20th? Must have been the 20th. No, I think it was the 10th. Because they'd been doing 8-bit like Spectrum games in the 80s. Ah, this is where I get to repair my car. But I'm actually quite happy with the state of everything. Look at that. You don't want to spend all your money on this sort of thing. This was where this game fell down for me. I'd run out of money. Basically, my car would get damaged to hell and I'd run out of money. And that was the end of it. I think if you get good at it, though, you know, you can be upgrading and buying better cars. And I know later on you get to drive better cars. I never got there. Never got beyond these two cars. The Mini and the Cinquecento. This game plays actually better than I remember it playing. Maybe I was just rubbish at it back then. Ooh, race me. This is where we find out how badly it plays. How hard it is. Or how badly I play it. Yeah, there you go. That mini's gone. That's the last we'll see of him. There's no way you're going to win this race, I think. Even when you get good at it, I've never really stood a chance against him. I'd love that. Oh, what's the backwards control? Is it just pull back? I've forgotten how to go backwards. Is it space? Yeah, space reverse. Yeah, we've lost this race. Come on. Or you just pull back in space again. Yeah, probably should have looked that up. Never mind. We live and learn. So already, the pace of the game has changed considerably. Love the thunderstorm effect. Love the rain effect. Love all the little people at the side of the road. I remember when I was putting them in. Particularly loving those. And thinking I'd make a point of aiming at them. But there's no way you can get through the foliage of this map. That was pretty bad. I'm going to get lapped, aren't I? I'm going to get lapped. Oh, this is pretty bad. Oh, I got him. Yeah, I mean, this is... I don't know if it's a flaw, just a flaw in the way I'm playing it. I think there's an element of a flaw in the game. It's not... Once you start getting battered by another car like this, it kind of loses its fun element. That said, I know I've played much better at it. I still believe it's not a bad game. There was a rally game like this on the arcades. I can't remember what it was called. I saw a video recently that featured it. And it was beautiful. It was this, but with the freedom, without the directional limit thing. And it's kind of a shame that they did that. I'm just messing with my gears. If you pull back, it goes down again. It's just a shame they did that. I remember being disappointed by that when I first actually played the game. I built all the backgrounds without actually ever playing the game. They were doing the programming upstairs. But I did love the way all the cars were rendered. And I was expecting the game to be a much freer experience to play, you know. Oh no, I've been proper lapped. I've got to do the lap of shame now. I bet my car's been a bit damaged too. Oh, this is embarrassing. Look at them all taking pictures of me. Is that the lightning or the camera flashes? Don't look at me. I'm making it worse. But yeah, game I was quite proud to work on at the time. It didn't really have any commercial success, this one. It just kind of existed, you know. Oh, that was pretty bad. I think that might be a game over just for being so bad. You have definitely failed to qualify. I've never done that badly. I wonder if I'll get another go. Yeah, I think I do. Awesome, let's do it. Let's do better this time. Can't do much worse, let's face it. Go on, we'll give it one more go and then I'll call it a day there. Yeah, so what I did on this was basically build... Ooh, 40%. Oh, I've saved a lot of money. What have I? Yeah, pretty much. And suddenly, the game is over. We've got a damaged car. I think if any of that gets to 100%, you basically die. I remember having a conversation with Ali about the car and asking if they'd consider like damaging the car. You know, I was totally naive. I didn't realize how much work would go into damage models, different damage in different areas and stuff like that. But basically, the bottom line was the manufacturers had outright refused to allow to see the cars damaged in the game. So you never actually do. That's why you never see them damaged. Well, that's the official story. I think they'll really, let's face it, the amount of work that would go into damaging these cars. They're not like Hot Wheel crack-ups, you know. You've got to, if you hit something on the right, you've got to kind of damage it on the right. It's not like a 3D model. You can't just mess with the shell of it, you know, with the mesh. These are rendered sprites. I'm doing a bit better this time, let's face it. I might actually make it through on time. I'm just going to try not to... See, now I'm concentrating and hitting everything. I wasn't concentrating, I was just talking bubbles. Bubbles. That was a combination of bubbles and bobbins. I'm talking bobbins and bubbles. and doing better for it. Oh, it's getting wobbly. I think this game came out on the Mega Drive as well. I think it was done by someone else though, and the graphics were a bit bigger if I remember right. A bit more colourful as well, considering, all things considered, that's pretty pretty good achievement. Yeah, I'm not too ashamed of this one. I'm nowhere near as ashamed of this as I was of Batman Returns. Although I didn't really have much input on Batman Returns. But as I say, I could have helped influence that game in a better direction. Looking back, I know that now. This, on the other hand, was, you know, the coding was kind of there. It was a port, essentially, of a fairly well-received game, I think. I enjoyed working on it. I was made up to get my name on the credits. I can't tell you how made up I was for that. But yeah, if you can ever be bothered, sit through the front end for 5 minutes, you'll see Ali Noble comes up and Mike Hansen comes up underneath, and that's me. Am I running out of time here? I thought that was my last lap. That mini's only just ahead of me though. He's still going round. I'm not doing too badly here. Don't think I'll ever catch him, but definitely going for a qualifier now. But yeah, old Mikey's on the credit to this one. All that greenery you see there, you can see there's a lot of repetition. Basically because I made swatches with brushes, you know. I got the hang of making the brushes and repeating the bits that you don't really see very much. Oh, I was looking at the background like an idiot. They say when you're driving, you always drive towards what you're looking at. And I just drove right into the background and hit the mini. Oh, not quite. Yeah, so there it is. I think the next level is a night stage one where you've got your headlights on, which is such a cool touch. I'll just get it to that point so we can see a bit of it. Yeah, night it is. I think this is about as far as I got. I might have got a couple more levels in, but I never really saw much of this game. There were a lot of levels. There were a lot of backgrounds. There was a lot of work in putting this game together. And I was definitely on the front line of that. Loved every moment of it though. Excuse me. I think I was 15, maybe 16 by then. 16, I would have been 16 then. And I was so proud to be working on published Amiga games. Not really realising that the Amiga was pretty much dead by 1994. And that this was the last year anyone was going to make games for it. That's right, as your car gets damaged, the lights start to flicker more and more. And it gets harder and harder to see. I mean, that is hard. I don't care however you look at it, that is hard. We're not really using the lights, we're just trying really hard to see the track in the dark. I think when the lights finally die, it'll actually make life easier because you won't have those things flickering around the front of you. It's a nice touch though, isn't it? Dithered edges on those headlights. It really works. I mean, it doesn't help, but it works. It's nicely made. I'm totally pulling back way too much and skidding all over the place. I'd say the controls were really quite unique, and some would say flawed, and I'd be kind of inclined to agree. They weren't. I feel like they were made this way out of the limitations of what they were trying to do, rather than out of a conscious decision, you know, a conscious and deliberate decision to make the controls work this way. It doesn't feel like they wanted it to be like this. It can be made to work though when you get a bit of practicing. Anyway, I'll leave that there. Not a bad game. I worked on that. Power Drive, Commodore Amiga. Thanks for watching.